Hey guys, welcome to XWF. You know, straight in with the owner. He says, last week, a certain group of individuals went against my authority. Now that's true, we all know who he's talking about. He says there is going to be big repercussions for that. You know, the owner, he's going to enforce these rules, he's going to enforce his law. He says one might even say that desperate measures are going to be taken. He says later tonight, I will inform this crusade and all the XWF fans of my plans. Okay, so we've got a limo pulling up in the parking lot. You know, who could it be getting out? Well, we're going to find out right now. The doors open in. Oh, God. I know who it is. It's freaking Dr. Karn. He's an idiot. He's trying to lead a new crusade. The crusade happened in 2007 in the XWA. We're now in the XWF 2012. You can't do a crusade against this CWO. And there's Johnny Kamikaze. He was in the original crusade. Now we got Titus Valentine, who's a new internet champion. He doesn't deserve it. And the new guy, Tsunami, who is in the No Holds Barred Championship. And damage straight to the owner's office here, you know, as soon as the show starts. And he says, owner, I want Karn tonight. Oh my God, he wants Karn tonight? The owner says, look, damage, listen. After all that happened last week, we need a plan. The owner's got his head screwed on. He says, we can't just rush you into a match against the doctor. I agree. The owner says, if the crusade want to attack us, then they will learn that you don't mess with us. He says, first off, we need all of the belts back in our possession. The owner, he knows exactly what he's talking about. He says, rest out of the ring tonight, and I'll rematch you against Tsunami at pay-per-view. Oh my God, a rematch. Well, Damage says, owner, I will get the No Holds Barred title back, but give me Karn first. And the owner says, I will think about it. You know, that's fair in my opinion. Either way, guys, you know, sorry to make it so informal. You guys haven't had a chance to see me yet because we've been so hectic. But I'm the Bear, and this is XWF 13. The news, you know, I might as well fill you guys in. Johnny Kamikaze started his career in 2005 in the XWA, is now in the XWF. And he's spearheading the new crusade with Dr. Karn. You know, they were in the crusade back in 05 and 07, 06, whatever. I don't care when it was. Forget that. Because tonight, me versus Angus, the dick, the faggot, the idiot. And then, the owner is going to speak tonight. Because he's got big news. I'm not going to say anything, but I think it's regarding pay-per-view 3, but we'll see, you know, I didn't say that, you didn't hear that from me, I don't want to get fired. Now Havoc is coming into the owner's office, and he says, owner, I heard you wanted to talk to me. And the owner says, yes, Havoc, I did, listen up. I plan on Jacob Drake taking on Titus Valentine tonight. Do it, owner, let Jacob Drake win the title back. And the owner says, but I figured I'd give you a chance, so I'm booking you versus Titus tonight. Hit him hard and win that internet title. And Havoc says, you got it, boss. Oh my God, Havoc against Titus tonight. You know, for the internet championship, I'm saying Havoc. Havoc is gonna be the new internet champion. And I'm like, wait, what? It's now? The match is freaking now? I thought this was going to be the main event or something. I'm up for it. This is a great way to start the show. Great way to open. You know, somebody get me some popcorn. Somebody get me some soda. You know, I don't care. Get me a freaking cheeseburger. I don't care. Anything. Just something I can munch while I'm watching this match, because it's going to be great. You know, I'm not a massive fan of Titus Valentine, especially now that he's in the freaking crusade. Like, oh, we're going to stop the CWO. You're not going to stop the CWO. Ever. But even so, you know, the fans are crazy for Titus. They're cheering. They're cheering even more now because he's got the internet title around his waist, which he didn't win fairly. But yeah, you know, Havoc is going to destroy Titus Valentine tonight. I'm so sure of it. If it was in the bookies, you know, it would be 100-1. You know, I don't even know what 100-1 means, but it sounds good. Either way, what I'm trying to say is this guy right here, Havoc, is gonna win. That's all I'm trying to say. I was just trying to gloss it and make it sound good. That's all I'm saying. But, you know, the fans are booing Havoc, and they're booing him because he was in T-Unit, and they said, Havoc's rubbish, he's in T-Unit, he'll never get anywhere. Where is he now? He's fighting for the internet title. You guys are all losers. I'm right, you're wrong. And that guy in the crowd, you know, you're trying to argue with me. No, you can't argue with me. In fact, if you want to come in the ring later on, I'll beat Angus, then I'll beat you. I'll break your freaking legs. Security, can you take that guy out, please? Because he's bad-mouthing me. I don't like it. Security, take that guy out there. Get that guy over there. The one in the blue loin shirt. Get him out here. Yeah, that's the one. Take him out. Yeah, that's right. And Havoc's in the ring, you know. He's sturdy. He's beefed up. He's ready. You know, who did he beat the other week? Oh, was it Mike Jacobs? Yes, it was Mike Jacobs. And now he's going to beat Titus. Either way, the ref, you know, rings the bell. So let's get this started. Oh, Titus with a vicious kick. Cheap kick to the ribs. Now tying up, who's the stronger man? Havoc with a great headlock. Elbow to the back of the head is what I love about Havoc. Look at this. Straight in with the Irish whip into the corner. Massive clothesline. Beheading Titus and then dropping an elbow onto the chest. Great move from Havoc. Titus Valentine doesn't even know where he is. Havoc, look at this, lifting him up, Samoan drop, signature, slamming down. You know, Havoc, very useful, very resourceful with his Samoan drops, and Titus Valentine elbows out. This is the only thing he can do is use his elbows. Massive release German suplex, but it didn't really look safe to me. If I was the ref, I would end this match and give the belt to Havoc at that point. But say what you want, headlock here from Titus Valentine, knee to the face again. Vicious, he has to resort to this brutality, and what the hell? He just jumps onto the game, hot shot, man, cheap. You know, the crusade call CWO cheap, and they pull moves like that. And what the hell? They just suplex Havoc to the outside. You know, surely the ref can't let this go on. Oh my god, Titus straight off the apron, a massive clothesline, nailing him, and now T-Bone suplex on the outside. You know, I don't know where this new fierce nature has come. Is it because Titus is now in the crusade that he thinks he's now pushing himself to the limit? A massive elbow to the jaw of Havoc. But, you know, Titus, you can push yourself all you want. Oh, here we go. Havoc locking him over. Oh, suplex into the ring. You know, that is a precision suplex, not some half-assed effort to the outside of the ring. Pathetic. Havoc rushing leg sweep, slamming down on Titus Valentine. Now, Titus Valentine, you've had your little chance in this match now. Havoc's gonna decimate you. Another Russian next week. You know, Havoc's all over Titus Valentine now. I can smell the internet title. I can smell, oh, again, a vicious elbow from Titus. What do we expect from Titus? Oh, German suplex again. You know, the ref really needs to stop this guy. And look at these shoulder butts to the ribs. You know, no wrestling. This isn't wrestling. Oh, I need, oh my god. The ref needs to sort this out. Now, Titus Valentine, using a bit of mat wrestling here to try and prove that he's a wrestler. He's not. He came from UFC. You're UFC. You're mixed martial arts. You're not a wrestler. Havoc using a headlock here. Elbow to the back of the head. Great elbow. Great wrestling move there. Now an armbar. Oh, look at this armbar on the floor. Locking him in. How does that feel, Titus? How does that feel? You know, I just don't think Titus Valentine deserves the Internet Championship. At the end of the day, you know, Jacob Drake, he held it for so long, gave it so much credibility. Oh, great man, had to drop clothesline. Oh, massive. You know, Jacob Drake, he gave the belt so much credibility. Now it's in the hands of the Crusade. Instantly drops the credibility, none. Instantly drops the price to nothing. Instantly just makes it look like crap. But all the fans, they love the Crusade. You know, we're getting Twitter, we're getting Facebook, we're getting messages. Oh my God, the Crusade's back. Can't believe Johnny Kamikaze's back in the XWF. Dr. Karn and Kamikaze together again. No one will ever beat them. You know, I don't know where the fans are getting this crap from. Johnny Kamikaze, you know, what has he done? Wow, so he won a couple of matches in 2007. I'll cover one, two, oh no, a kick out just before the free from Havoc there. You know, what has Johnny Kamikaze achieved in his career? Not a lot. The only reason he's known is because he jumped on the anti-TWO train and took a nice ride up to the top. And that's exactly what he did in the XWF. If he didn't anti-CWO, if he didn't join the Crusade, he would be a nobody. Because he went against the rules. You know, he had to be a vigilante. He had to be a renegade. And all the fans jump on board. Does he have any wrestling talent? No. End of. But all the fans, as I say, they love him. A great DDT there from Havoc. What the hell? Are you freaking kidding me? The Rebel is coming out onto the stage in a freaking pink top. He looks like an idiot. And he says, hey, Havoc, you really think you can become the Internet Champion? Yes, of course he can, if you don't freaking get involved in the matches. For God's sake. The Rebel says, you're nothing since you left T-Unit. And now you're trying for gold. And he starts laughing. Laughing. The Rebel says, CWO will soon see that you're worthless. Then you'll be coming back to us. Bye, Havoc. Oh my God, you know, I hate the Rebel. What the hell is he wearing them glasses for? Looks like an idiot. All right, let's just get back to the match. Ignore the interruption. Oh, what the hell? Heartbreaker! No. Oh my God, he's locked it in. Havoc, you gotta kick out. That's one, two, three. I don't believe it. I do not freaking believe what I've just seen. That is all the Rebels for. Havoc would have won. He would be the Internet Champion. He would bring that gold back to the CWO. But no, the Rebel has to get involved with his shitty little glasses and his stupid pink top. He's an idiot. What the hell? Oh my God. This is his entry. What? It's Angus. Angus, the guy who came on the XWF YouTube channel and started slagging us off. You know, the only guy in the world that is worse than the Rebel. Angus, he wants to take me on. I challenged him, and he accepted. He said I was polluting YouTube. He's pathetic. In fact, I even told them to be pathetic in front of his name on the stream. How do you feel? Look at his hair, look at his clothes, look at his glasses. He's a prick, he's a faggot, he's an idiot, he's a cocksucker, I don't even know what he is. But you know what? I don't know. I'm not saying anything more. Words, no more. I'm gonna get in the ring, I'm gonna do what needs to be done. And that is, show why I am one-time hardcore champion. That's right, watch Angus, he's 50-time gay champion, 70-time cocksucking champion. He's a prick. Always one-time prick champion, but I don't care, because I'm going to kick his ass, and you're going to see. Get your stop clocks ready, because I'm going to go fuck this guy up so hard. You know, there's going to be nothing left of him. I'm going to break every limb. I'm going to decimate him. You're going to see my special. You're going to see my special. In fact, I'm going now. See you in a second. That's right, you goddamn piece of shit. The bear wins against Angus. And now we're going backstage. And Havoc is speaking to the Gribble. And Havoc says, Gribble, what the hell is your problem? And the Gribble says, easy, Havoc. Easy. And Havoc says, no, Gribble. You've crossed the line. In fact, I've had it up to here with your shit. You know, Havoc's pissed off. You're in big trouble, Gribble. Havoc says, we end this once and for all. Me versus you at pay-per-view. If you win, I'll come back to you. And what the hell, Havoc? No. Don't say that. You'll win. Don't say that. And Havoc says, I'll see you at pay-per-view. And he leaves. And the Gribble's like, Havoc, wait. But then Havoc's pissed off and he's gone. So, what? Is that official? Are we going to see Havoc versus the Gribble at pay-per-view? That's crazy. Now we're backstage with Mike Jacobs and Kamikaze. What the hell? And Jacobs says, well, you must be Johnny Kamikaze. I've heard a lot about him. Yeah, it's all crap because there's nothing good to know about him. And he's Mike Jacobs, he says, it's all hype. Wow, so you won a few low-key matches in a low-key fed back in 07. Exactly, Mike Jacobs, exactly. And Jacobs says, why don't you show all the XWF fans if you can live up to the hype and take me on tonight? And Johnny Kamikaze says, all right, you're on. And Mike Jacobs says, well, I'll see you in the ring. And he leaves. Oh, my God, Johnny Kamikaze, you're fucked. You can't beat Mike Jacobs. Mike Jacobs is one of the best pound-for-pound wrestlers in the XWF. So tonight, we're going to see Johnny Kamikaze versus Mike Jacobs. It's official. Can't wait. Damage is in the owner's office again. And he says, you know, have you thought about me versus Karn tonight? And the owner says, actually, I have. Wait for my announcement later tonight. What the hell does that mean? Either way, we're kicking back into the matches straight away. We've had some great in-ring action tonight. Preferably me destroying Angus. I think that's match of the year candidate. But either way, you know, Mike Jacobs versus Kamikaze. And all of you fans out there are going to see that Johnny Kamikaze is nothing but a fraud. Nothing but a wrestler who's been bigged up when really he's got nothing to back it up. A guy that can talk the talk, but he can't walk the walk. That's Johnny Kamikaze for you. I got some messages on Twitter actually bigging my matchup against Angus, because Angus is an idiot. You know, did you see me giving the bear driver all the way to hell? You know, I thought for a second, I might not even pin him. I might just go and get a soda, drink it, come back and then pin him and I'd still win. But, you know, I thought I'd get over with. Just, you want to get out of the wrestling, not Angus, the prick, the faggot, the cocksucker. He's an idiot. But, you know, I'm hoping that's the last thing we see of Angus and the last thing we hear of Angus. And if he wants a match against me again, I'll do exactly the same thing. You know, fuck you, Angus, you prick. And, no more words about Angus. I don't want to hear about Angus anymore in the XWF. Angus is a prick. Either way, Mike Jacobs versus Johnny Kamikaze live tonight. And I can't wait, because Johnny Kamikaze, you know, this is his debut match. Yeah, fine, he can come into the XWF. He can sneak up behind Nightmare when Nightmare's not looking. Give him a Tiger Bomb. You know what? I don't give a shit about the Tiger Bomb. I don't give a shit about Johnny Kamikaze. Because this is his debut match, and he's going against Mike Jacobs. You know, I'm sorry, Kamikaze. You can't beat Mike Jacobs. In fact, you can't beat anyone. I'd like to see Johnny Kamikaze versus Angus. That would be the worst match in the history of wrestling. And I don't even know if Johnny Kamikaze would win. You know, Angus is a bit idiot. He's a faggot. He's a prick. But I don't know. Johnny Kamikaze, he fits in all them criteria as well. So, you know, that would definitely be the most boring wrestling match in history. But, you know, we're going to start talking crap because this is the match and it's tonight. I just love it. I just love it because I love Mike Jacobs and I hate Johnny Kamikaze. And I know that Mike Jacobs is amazing and Johnny Kamikaze is, well, the equivalent of horse manure mixed up in a blender. Crap. So let's get this match on the road and Johnny Kamikaze stretching his neck all cocky. I'm betting this match will last about 3 seconds. That tying up, you know, who's the stronger man? What the hell? Kamikaze getting a headlock in on Mike Jacobs makes me laugh. Because Mike Jacobs turns his arm inside out, shows him some... What the hell? Johnny Kamikaze turns into a headlock of his own. What the hell? Lifting the arm up. Look at this. Heart punch. Vicious heart punch from Johnny Kamikaze. Now they're throwing these punches, brawling because he can't wrestle. Under the arm. Oh my god! Clotheslining Mike Jacobs' head off. Johnny Kamikaze pointing to his head, cocky, and the fans go crazy. I have no idea why. That's one. Got a kick out on one there by Mike Jacobs. Did Kamikaze really think he could pin Mike Jacobs after a clothesline? This is exactly the trash that I'm talking about with Johnny Kamikaze. And an arm ring there, and now Mike Jacobs in control for the rest of the match. Look at this slipping under. Nothing Kamikaze can do. High angle backdrop slamming down on the shoulders. Johnny Kamikaze is a pulp. He's just a pulp. Absolutely destroyed. Mike Jacobs clotheslining his head off. Guillotining, clotheslining his head straight off. Mike Jacobs turning around. Elbow. Russian leg sweep, and he jumps. I love the way Mike Jacobs jumps when he does a Russian leg sweep. The extra pain and extra pressure. Now a snapmare into a reverse chin lock. How many moves has Johnny Kamikaze done today? None. He's done a couple of punches and a clothesline. Not one single wrestling move. And that is exactly the sort of shit I'm talking about with Johnny Kamikaze. Using his head as a battering ram there to get out of the hold. Johnny Kamikaze using an Irish whip. Wow. Oh, a massive body splash in the corner. Again, not a real wrestling move because Johnny Kamikaze doesn't wrestle. He just brawls. He shouldn't be in wrestling. Look, Johnny Kamikaze, massive slap there. Now just bending down and just slamming Mike Jacobs' head on the mat. I'm just waiting to see how many wrestling moves. Oh, a spinebuster, sitting down spinebuster. All right, you know, into a pin. But Mike Jacobs gets the rope. Great ring awareness. So Johnny Kamikaze's done one wrestling move all match. Well done, Kamikaze. I bet you feel special. That tying up, who's the stronger man? Who's the stronger man? Mike Jacobs slips under because he's the most technical. Clothesline, but Johnny Kamikaze ducks and... Oh, he flips over. Float over DDT. Wow, the second move in the match from Kamikaze. Second wrestling move. Great. Johnny Kamikaze slipping under, slipping behind. Hold in, but Mike Jacobs turns into a headlock with great technique. Massive punch. Massive punch. That's how you punch someone, Kamikaze. Not your pathetic excuses for a punch. Arm drag there. Mike Jacobs showing once again why he is one of the greatest pound-for-pound wrestlers the world's ever seen. And another arm drag. Kamikaze taking a beating. And unfortunately for the fans, not being able to dish one out back. And another arm drag from Mike Jacobs. You know, Mike Jacobs now with his elbows to the shoulder, really winding. Really knocking the air out of Johnny Kamikaze. And Johnny Kamikaze, he's not really done much. Have you, Kamikaze? Your first match in the XWF. This is great. And here we go. Mike Jacobs lifting him up for the top. Superplex coming up. Look, just throwing punches to daze him off. Kamikaze kicks Mike Jacobs back. Oh, missile dropkick from the top rope. You know, it wasn't very good. It wasn't very good. And a chop block there. And again, you know, Johnny Kamikaze goes back. They're just brawling in a wrestling ring. Why does he do wrestling if he's just going to brawl and not do any wrestling moves? I just don't see the point of it. Look, a jumping knee to the face. Again, not a wrestling move, just a brawling move, because that's all Kamikaze can do. Off the ropes and a massive shoulder. Wow, a shoulder. And now Johnny Kamikaze's best wrestling move just grabs your leg and jumps back with it. Great. Great Kamikaze, really going to be a world champion with that move. Really going to be the internet champion. Oh, again, a massive clothesline, and Kamikaze gets cocky, taps his head. Why does he tap his head? Because he did a clothesline. Wow. Oh, and here we go, a signature maneuver. These bionic elbows slamming on Mike Jacobs' forehead, and another one. That's his signature. He just elbows you in the face 5 times. Well done, Kamikaze. Inventive. And he's waking up. Ah, he went for a tiger bomb, but Mike Jacobs is too clever. Look at this. Locks it in. Massive vertical suplex. Decimating. And now he grabs Johnny Kamikaze's head and smashes on a mat. Over and over again. This is what you get, Kamikaze, because he torns Mike Jacobs up. He says, "Oh, I'm gonna do a tiger bomb on Mike Jacobs. Tiger bomb. Get up, get up." He gives him time to recover, like an idiot. You don't give Mike Jacobs time to recover, because Mike Jacobs gets up, turns around, and suplexes your ass all the way to next week. And that's exactly what he did. Massive hip toss there, Kamikaze. is in a bad way. Mike Jacobs using this crossbody stretch here with a knee in the back, just stretching Kamikaze's body. And Kamikaze, he's looking like he's winded. He's looking like he's passing out. In fact, he might even give up because his foot is still far away from the rope. He cannot get a rope breaking. Oh, Kamikaze finds the strength to flip Mike Jacobs over. Mike Jacobs turns around, and Kamikaze, look, here we go, armbar. Really good wrestling move coming up. No, it's not, because Mike Jacobs turns into a headlock and a massive punch to the face. It's like a brick hitting you in the face, and Kamikaze's angry. Pinfall, a massive shoulder block. Kamikaze off the rope. Another shoulder block, the best of his repertoire. Mike Jacobs goes for a punch. Kamikaze underneath. Spin-out powerbomb there. And Kamikaze lifting Mike Jacobs up. I don't believe it. A tiger bomb. No way. And he nails it. No, no, no. That's one, two, three. That's it. Kamikaze beat Mike Jacobs. Mike Jacobs, you know, I don't know. No, 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 no. Why are the fans cheering? Why are the fans cheering? Because Kamikaze won his first match in the XWF. That's rubbish. Mike Jacobs is leaving. Oh, what the hell? Tobias Upson just ripped Mike Jacobs' legs out, picking Mike Jacobs up. What the hell? An Upson down on the outside. Oh, my God. Vicious from Tobias Upson. And he leaves. You know, Tobias Upson is playing with fire. He's been playing with fire for a long time. Now, Dr. Karn backstage with Tsunami, and he says, both Titus Valentine and Johnny Kamikaze won their matches tonight. So me and Tsunami here, we had an idea. What's the idea, Doctor? Because it's going to be a crap idea, I can tell already. He says, we want to go for a full crusade sweep tonight. So what them two want matches as well. And he says, me and Tsunami here, we challenge the CWO to a tag match tonight. Challenge. Challenge. CWO are going to kick their goddamn asses. And Dr. Karn says, let's see if you've got the balls, CWO. Got the balls? Are you freaking kidding me? CWO are going to absolutely decimate these guys. Nightmare Damage. That's my team. There we go. Nightmare Damage going backstage. They're accepting the challenge. Nightmare says, owner. You know, what's Nightmare going to say? He says, the Crusade. Just challenge us. I love Nightmare Damage. Bang on it straight away. As soon as the challenge, straight into the owner's office. Damage says, put me a Nightmare in the main event. Then I can kick Karn and Tsunami's asses. You know, that's it. Kills two birds with one stone. And the owner says, guys, this is exactly what the Crusade want. They are trying to break us down. They're trying to get themselves in the barnage. Pay-per-view. You know, the owner is a clever man. He says, ideally, I don't want either of you to wrestle before pay-per-view. But I know, Damage, I know that you want them. So what I say is, Nightmare, you rest out tonight. And I'll arrange for Jacob Drake to be your partner tonight. Damage. Damage says, well, you got yourself a deal. And he says, I'm still finalizing the plans for pay-per-view, the card. You know, I will announce it tonight. So the owner's still going to announce the pay-per-view card. I have no idea what the matches are. But tonight, the main event will be Jacob Drake and Damage versus Dr. Karn and Tsunami, CWO versus the Crusade. And now Mike Jacobs going into the owner's office. And Mike Jacobs says, owner, listen up. Did you see what that little brat Tobias Upson did to me after my match tonight? I've had enough of that cocky little son of a bitch. You know, Mike Jacobs is so pissed off. I've never heard him this pissed off. He says, I don't care what you've got planned for the next pay-per-view. I want Upson. In fact, I've had enough of that little prick cheap-shotting me. I'm running away. I want him one-on-one, but with no escape. Give me Upson in a cage. What the hell? Are you freaking kidding me? And the owner says, look, Mike Jacobs, I respect you. I will take your ideas into consideration, but nothing is final yet. But I will announce the pay-per-view card tonight. You know, Tobias Upson, you're in big trouble, man, because Mike Jacobs wants you in a cage. You know, I'm scared of Mike Jacobs on the best of days, but in a cage, that is going to be a scary, scary thing if that match goes through. Now, Dr. Karn making his way down to the ring. You know, oh, he's got new pants. little white pants today with a design on them. You know, I'm not gonna lie, actually, they do look quite good. You know, goes with the hair and stuff, but it doesn't change the fact that CWO are gonna decimate the Crusade tonight. That's just the way it goes. Because, you know, it's... Wait, who have we got? We got Damage and Jacob Drake. You know, Jacob Drake's first main event, apart from on Aftershock, his first main event on the XWF main show, and he's gonna shine. Because I love Jacob Drake, you know, and, you know, the fans boo him, but he is the longest reigning internet champion ever. Ever. That's the facts, and you fans cannot argue with that. Anyway, you know, Dr. Karn is getting into the ring, sporting these new pants, sporting crowd with a sign saying Dr. fucking Karn, because they love Karn. They think he's the greatest thing since sliced bread. Well, they're gonna learn tonight that Karn is nothing. You know, don't, no, I'll take that back. Karn is a great wrestler, I've got respect for the guy. But when he pulls shit like this, the Crusade, he did it in 2007, and yes, he was successful. But he's not gonna be successful, not in the XWF. The Crusade was a one-off chance, and it was lucky. It was luck. That's it. And now, the CWO is stronger and better, and you can bring in guys like this guy, Tsunami, a big blue-haired son of a bitch that you can hit in the face with a baseball bat, and they'll just look at you like nothing happened. But it doesn't matter, because let me tell you, Damage is the best no-holds-barred champion ever, and he's gonna take that belt back. I don't care how he does it, he's gonna do it. Jacob Drake or Havoc is gonna take that internet title back. Nightmare is still the world champion, so he doesn't have to take that back. And then, CWO are gonna go and get the Hardcore Hate Crew, and they're gonna take the tag titles back. And the CWO will have every title again. And that was the best way. When XWF was like that, everything was under control. The CWO were peaking at the top, they had all of the belts, and there was nothing to worry about. But then, you know, Dr. Karn, he has to bring in the Crusade, with all these rebellion, with all these Crusaders who think they can get something, who think the fans are going to get behind them. It doesn't achieve anything. I do not see a point of the Crusade, not against this CWO. Dr. Karn's wasting his time. All he's doing is making more annoyance for the owner, because the owner has to clean this shit up. And that's why he sends Damage down, because Damage is the enforcer. Damage is the no-holds-bar champion. He's not at the moment, but he is the best champion we've ever seen in the XWF. And the only he's technically, in my eyes, he is still the champion. Because Tsunami, he came down when Damage and Karn were in this really hench battle. And Damage had it won. Damage had beat Dr. Karn. That's it. You heard it right. Damage had beaten Dr. Karn. It was over. All Damage had to do was pin it. Then this big blue guy who wasn't even on the roster runs in and cyborg slams Damage all the way to hell. Cheap. Cheap as chips. They take the belt. Look at us. We're no holds barred champion. You're a prick, mate. You're an idiot. And either way, Damage is gonna take that no holds barred championship back. I'm gonna stop slagging off the blue guy, because, you know, last time I slagged Big D off, you know what happened. So maybe slagging the big guys off isn't a good idea. But either way, I'm really looking forward to seeing Jacob Drake in a main event. You know, he's going to be able to show all the fans that boo him and say, here he is, he turns up now. Jacob Drake, the fans are booing him. I don't care. I don't think he cares either. He's the longest reigning internet champion. You're nothing. And look at him just corning on the stage and winding the crowd up. I love Jacob Drake. He's so good. You know, he's got a new attire just for today because he made the band. He's got his own Jacob Drake shirt. He's got a little gray hoodie on, a little gold chain, a red bandana. We don't very often see that. So, you know, he means business. He's got nice new red trainers. You know, he changes his trainers every week. I don't know why he does, but he does. But Jacob Drake, you know, I'm really looking forward to see how he can hold himself up. And maybe even win the match. I'm saying Jacob Drake's gonna pin Dr. Karn. That's my prediction, and I would love to see that. If that does happen tonight, ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna cut just that 10-second clip of Jacob Drake pinning Dr. Karn on the ref's hand going 1, 2, 3. I'm gonna cut just that chunk out, and I'm gonna put it on YouTube, and I'm gonna upload it on YouTube. Upload it on YouTube. Upload it. I'm gonna upload about 150 versions of it, and I'm just gonna name it. All different names. Anything. Lady Gaga, Justin Bieber, whatever. And everyone in the world is gonna see Jacob Drake pin Dr. Karn. I can't wait. I just can't wait. And that's my plan anyway. That's my predictions. Let's get this show on the road. Karn and Damage starting the match here. You know, they're locking horns. Who's the stronger man? And Karn uses an arm bar here. Can Damage turn it into his own? There he goes. Slips behind, holding Karn around the waist. Turns Karn around into a headlock. Damage showing that he can be just as technical as Dr. Karn when he wants. Armbar here, kick to the ribs. Dr. Karn got beat at his own freaking game by Damage. Oh, an elbow to the stomach there by Dr. Karn. And Dr. Karn, again, using armbar here and then a wrench. He wants to prove that he's more technical than Damage. Look at this. Oh, backside slam. Slamming down on Damage's face and upper body. And Karn picks Damage up to his feet. Picks him up onto his shoulders. Oh, here we go. It's paid in at Oldham Homer slam. Slamming Damage on the floor. Great force and Damage. Throws Damage off the ropes here, running in, and Karn slips under his arm. German suplex, so vicious, slamming on the back of Damage's head. You know, he could get concussion from that damn move. And Karn throws him into the corner, tags in the monster tsunami. And they both whip Damage off the ropes. He comes back. Oh, look at this. Throw over the top on Damage. So high, such airtime, and then just slamming down on his back. Tsunami picking Damage up onto his shoulder. Just a shoulder stretch, you know, mounted on that shoulder, stretching the body, and an elbow drop to the back there. Tsunami lifting Damage up to his feet. What is he going to do here? Oh, he puts Damage up onto his shoulders. Oh, my God. Fireman slam. You know, one of these moves we see from Tsunami a lot, and he goes for the cover. That's one. Jacob Drake breaks the pin. You know, Jacob Drake, a CWO, he grabs Tsunami, elbow to the face of Tsunami. And Jacob Drake grabs Tsunami, and now Damage. Oh, Jacob Drake with a kick. Damage with a kick. And a double kick there from Damage and Jacob Drake. CWO showing off a double team prowess there. And Damage is time to take back control of the match on the DDT on Tsunami. Busting Tsunami's face into the mat. Damage whips Tsunami off the ropes here. Japanese arm drag. You know, a big move to do on such a big guy. But Tsunami took the full force of it. And Damage throws Tsunami out the corner. Tsunami is sitting up position. Damage goes to the top rope. Oh, look at this. Double-footed dropkick to the face of Tsunami. Decimating him. This is where CWO, you know, they're going to take back control of the match. Damage throws Tsunami into the CWO corner and tags in Jacob Drake. You know, what's our double team? A snapmare. Jacob Drake off the ropes. Massive boot to the face of Tsunami. Nearly kicking his head square off. And Jacob Drake, oh, spinning around neck breaker on Tsunami. You know, Jacob Drake proving he can play with the big boys. And a massive fist drop and a second fist drop there. Jacob Drake lifts Tsunami up. Tsunami manages to reverse it. Oh, my God. Taking Jacob Drake square off his feet there. And now Tsunami just throwing these huge punches at Jacob Drake. Puts Jacob Drake in a headlock, and what the hell? That was like an arm drag over his back, just decimating Jacob Drake. Oh no, not again. Puts Jacob Drake into that fireman slam, and slams him down. So vicious and such force from that move. And oh my God! Tsunami just took Jacob Drake's head off with a headbutt there, and another one, oh my God! Jacob Drake decimated. And Tsunami picks Jacob Drake up to his feet again, and just clubbing the hell out of Jacob Drake with these strong fists. And oh, now he mounts him up onto his shoulders. Another one of these stretching maneuvers. Just stretching the upper body of Jacob Drake. Squeezing the air right out of him. Tsunami tags in Dr. Karn. He needs a fresh man in. And Dr. Karn gets straight in for this arm bar on Jacob Drake. Come on, Drake. Get back into the match. And Dr. Karn now just throwing some punches at Jacob Drake and some slaps. And a kick to the ribs. And Dr. Karn puts Drake in a headlock. Well, look at this. Massive gut-wrench suplex there. Dr. Karn showing why he is one of the best suplexes in the business. And Karn throws Jacob Drake into the corner, running a massive clothesline, knocking the head off Jacob Drake. And now there's an arm stretch. Stretching the arm of poor Jacob Drake. You know, Jacob Drake, you really got to get yourself back into this match. You've been put in the main event by the owner. You've got to show you can, you know, you can be a main eventer. And oh my God, Oklahoma slam there from Dr. Karn. And Dr. Karn goes to the cover. Could this be over? That's one, two, and Damage gets in and breaks the pin. Good move. CWO watching each other's backs, you know. They won't just let any old pin go through. And Dr. Karn putting him up for another Oklahoma slam. Oh, Jacob Drake with an elbow to the forehead. This is a chance to get back into the match. You know, Jacob Drake, atomic drop there. Really attacking the lower body of Dr. Karn. Great move. Drake lifts Dr. Karn up. Locks him in. spin around neck breaker, slamming Dr. Carr on the mat. How does that feel, Doctor? How does that feel? You know, Jacob Drake getting revenge for early on in XWF when Dr. Carr kicked his head in a door. And Jacob Drake, the most infamous neck breaker in the world, slamming down on Dr. Carr. How does it feel? And Jacob Drake is torning up for a Drake break on the Doctor. Here it goes. He's locked it in. Amazing. A Drake break on Dr. Carr. This is over. This is over. That's 1, 2, 3. No, that was a 3. That ref needs firing. That was 100% a 3. I don't care what anyone says. Now Drake is back on the attack. Throws Karn off the ropes. A precision drop kick to the upper chest of Karn. And Drake is all over the Doctor now. And, you know, the owner is now seeing that putting Jacob Drake in a main event is a wise option. And Jacob Drake, look at this. Lifting Dr. Karn up into a suplex and falling forward, slamming the Doctor down onto the mat. Great move. Drake still on the attack, picking the Doctor up. And this time he throws the Doctor into Damage's corner. And, oh, I thought he was going to tag him in, but he runs straight in with a bulldog there. Drake, don't get cocky. You know, if you need to tag in, tag in. There we go, Drake making his way over and tagging in. He knew what he had to do. And, oh, a chop block there from Damage. Great move. Damage lifts up the legs of the Doctor, jumping over. Oh, a leg drop to the midsection. Precision. How does that feel, Doctor? And again, Damage locking it in. Another leg drop to the midsection. And Damage off the ropes. Look at this. Backflip. Double knees to the face of Doctor, just slamming him down. And he grabs his legs, another leg drop to the midsection. You know, that moonsault was absolutely stunning from Damage. Precision, double knees to the face. And Damage throws him into the corner, tags in Drake again. Tactical tag, snapmare to kick again. Great combo from the CWO. And Drake's turning another Drake break. He's on fire today. Oh, and Dr. Karn slips onto the Drake break. No, wait, stethoscope kick. Oh, my God. He's nailed Jacob Drake. And now Dr. Karn, no. Dr. Karn's torn in an operation. Oh, my God, he's locked it in. Drake, you got to find a way out of this. You've got to find, oh, operation. Decimated. Drake, you got to kick out of the pin. You've got to kick out of the pin. That's 1, 2. And Damage breaks the pin. Because Damage is CWO. And he saw a window of opportunity. Because this match, you know, Drake would have kicked out. But Damage was making sure Drake could kick out. And Drake's, you know, he slipped under. He's getting himself back into the battle. Dropkick to the back of Dr. Karn there. I don't know. Is Dr. Karn bleeding from something there? I'm not quite sure what split him open. It must have been that kick. And a CWO snapmare, the big kick to the face. Jacob Drake's boot has split the Doctor open. He seems to be bleeding all over the mat. He's holding his head. And Karn getting a tactical tag. Because he's obviously going to need to recover from that brutal shot to the head. And a massive double team hit toss. The elbow drop. Vicious. You know, I don't know if the paramedics are going to make their way down to check out Dr. Karn's head. Because it is bleeding refusively. And oh my God, Tsunami locking Jacob Drake in. Look at this. Suplex off the rope. Slingshotting Jacob Drake down in the mat. Decimating. Drake, you got to find your way back into this match. And Tsunami using this drop-down armbar. Drake doesn't tap, and Tsunami releases the hold. He wants to cause more pain on Jacob Drake. And oh my God, Tsunami with a massive shoulder block, but Drake gets a tag, and Damage on fire, knocking Tsunami out. Goes for, oh, Karn drops it down, and oh my God, he brought him on the ropes. No way! That massive sidewalk slam from Tsunami on Damage. This can't be over. That's 1, 2, 3. I don't believe it. I do not believe it. No way in hell did the Crusade just beat the CWO in the cheapest possible way. Because Dr. Karn had to use the ropes. He had to pull Damage's head down on the rope. Dr. Karn wasn't the legal man. But he pulled Damage's head down on the rope like a cheap son of a B-I-T-C-H son of a bitch. Dr. Karn, the Crusade, another point, another week with no losses. You know, CWO are not going to take kindly to this, and the Crusade are in big, big shit. What the hell? Big D's backstage with the owner, and Big D says, I don't know what your plans are for pay-per-view, owner, and quite frankly, I don't care. But you know that I am the number one contender for the No Holds Barred Championship. That is true. Big D is the number one contender for the No Holds Barred Championship. And the owner says, Big D, I'm making my way down to the ring now. and I'll be making the matches known. Big D says, well, I'll be watching. You know, I'd be scared. If I was the owner and Big D was demanding matches, I would be very scared. And the owner's walking down, and now Damage has stopped him, and Damage says, owner, did you just see what Khan did? Cheated us out of winning that tag match. It's true, Khan had to pull Damage down on the ropes like a cheap son of a bitch. And the owner said, yes, Damage, I saw. My mind is made up, and I'm going to announce the matches now. Great. Get the owner down here. I can't wait to see this. I can't wait to see what the owner's got planned for the third XWF pay-per-view. And yeah. Here is the limo, which just drives out on stage, drops the owner off, and the crowd are booing. Why are you booing the owner? He's about to tell you the matches for the pay-per-view, which all of you people are going to watch. And the owner's now going to tell you, and you're freaking booing him. But no, don't boo Johnny Kamikaze. Don't boo Dr. Khan, the Crusade, the people that are ruining the XWF with their crap. But oh no, we'll boo the owner, the guy that owns it, the guy that makes the matches, the guy that is responsible for the whole XWF, and you're freaking booing him. But all the fans don't care, they just keep booing. Booing. I'm booing every single one of you fans, you pieces of crap. You know, disgusting. You know, you want to watch yourself, because I will take on every single one of the members in that crowd. You will all be the next Angus. I will take you on one at a time. Maybe we'll do a whole show dedicated to me versus the whole crowd. Either way, the owner's got a mic. Let's hear what he's got to say. The owner says, look, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your patience. I will now announce Pay-Per-View 3. The XWF's third pay-per-view will be called Desperate Measures. I like it. I like the name. And the owner says, for the first time ever, we will have a dark match. Havoc versus the Grebel. Great, great. And the owner says, next on the bill, CWO's Jacob Drake will take on Titus Valentine for the internet title. Oh god, Jacob Drake is going to be the internet champion again. And the owner says, our third match will be for the No Holds Barred title, and it'll be Big D versus Tsunami. Tsunami, you're fucked. And the owner says, next, Mike the Viper Jacobs will take on Tobias Upson in a cage. Oh my god. I can't believe that's going through. The owner says, then we will have Damage versus Dr. Khan in a singles match. And our main event for the XWF world title will be Nightmare versus Johnny Kamikaze. Get your pay-per-view buys now. The show will not be one to be missed. You know what? Johnny Kamikaze does not deserve a title shot, but I can't wait to see Nightmare tear Johnny Kamikaze to pieces. And the owner says, I also have another big announcement that I have saved, especially for tonight. After Desperate Measures, the XWF will see a facelift. Alright, well, I'm interested. A new logo, and more of the Facebook integration that we trialed on show 11. And more importantly, our main show will now be called Shockwave. That's a great name, I like it. It goes well with Aftershock and stuff. That's great. You know, the owner, oh, that's a new logo, that's amazing! I love the new logo. Whoever made that, you're a legend. And that's the new Aftershock logo. Legend. You know, I love it. It's really going to make the XWF look more professional. And the owner says, thank you for your time, ladies and gentlemen. But what the hell? Johnny Kamikaze's here. Ref's coming in to try and stop it. No, my God! A tiger bomb on the... What the hell? No. Johnny Kamikaze, you have crossed the line. You're in big trouble, and we're off air. Oh my god.